Brittany Reimann from LA's The Place, and we're here with actor Jamie Harris. Thank you for joining us today.
What a pleasure.
Now, most audiences have most recently seen you in The Green Hornet.
Yes.
In the role of Popeye. Tell me a little bit about creating that role for the movie.
Well, that was an interesting role, really, because originally it was going to be Jamaican, and it was going to be Jamaican sort of drug lords doing their thing around town, as Jamaican drug lords would do. But then they redid it, and it sort of became more European. Christoph Waltz played the main bad guy, and I was his right-hand man, this sort of English character. And I think that I asked why they called it Popeye, because I'm very thin, and Chad Coleman is huge. And his name was very sort of weak sounding, and I had Popeye. But then I think it's because my eye pops out halfway through it. I couldn't work out why I was called Popeye. There were many reasons. So we created these characters that were great fun, just kind of challenging. We were allowed to do a lot of improvisation in the scenes, and Christoph is a hysterically funny actor. So we kind of just sort of fed off each other and had quite a good laugh. And my death scene, I think we shot it three times, three very different ways. And each time, I don't know why, I just annoyed him more. And so the death became this sort of grand thing about killing his right-hand man for no other reason than I was just annoying him.
After your roles in The Green Hornet and Rise of the Apes, you kind of had to switch gears for your role in Mr. Nice.
Yes.
And how did you mentally prepare for that character?
Well, it's a true story. So it's a very interesting true story set in the 70s. He was the story surrounds these three characters from Cambridge who were all very well educated, highly intelligent, a bunch of characters in the 70s who started smoking hashish, and they fell in love with hashish, and then they became the biggest importers to England, Ireland, and then America of that said product. And when Pink Floyd toured America in the 70s, unbeknownst to them, all their amps were full of hashish. And that's how they got caught, actually. Unfortunately, a dog came around and took a sniff. You're gonna get caught, son.
You also just finished filming Two Jacks, which is your third film with Bernard Rose, after Mr. Nice.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about that film.
Two Jacks is set in two eras of Hollywood. And it jumps between father and son. And it's a really interesting, it's a great story. It's based on I believe, Tolstoy short story. I play this character who comes to Hollywood, who's kind of wined and dined by this sort of very evil, devilish producer, who then takes me at poker, gets all my money, and then kind of rules what I do. It's very interesting. It's a really interesting take on Hollywood.
And
dark, but very funny.
Fantastic. And most of that film was improv, is that correct?
Yeah, it was improvised. But he had some great scenes. We shot at the Chateau Marmont and stuff, and some very interesting seedy bars, of which there are numerous in the city. And it was all improvised. Yeah, you get the basis of what the scene's about, and then you just let it go, and he just followed you with the camera, and he picked up moments he liked. It's a really fast way of shooting. I think he shot the entire movie in 10 days to 2 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah, and I just did the ADR yesterday, and it looks amazing.
Great.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
Now, your father is the legendary, world-renowned actor Richard Harris.
Yeah.
When did you know you wanted to pursue acting in your life?
Oh, I really didn't want to pursue acting, actually. I wanted to be a rock star like every young kid. And I pursued that to Dublin, and I was in a band in Dublin for a couple of years. And I think I made my uncle, actually, I think I made him slightly deaf, because the music was very loud in those days. And everybody in those days was in a band. But they were great music. It's not like nowadays. Then you had to be able to play an instrument back then. There wasn't some kind of machine that equalized you and turned every bad note into a good note. And I can vouch for that, because there were a lot of bad notes. But we were good. We were a good band. We were a good psychedelic rock band. So no, I didn't want to be an actor. And actually, the person who kind of convinced me to act was Jim Sheridan, who's a very famous Irish director, who worked with my father on The Field. And I worked on the field as a runner, which is a very badly paid job where you kind of, you're basically working, I think, 23 hours out of 24, getting coffee and rubbish. But I had an amazing time, amazing time. And I got very close with Jim Sheridan, and he was the one who suggested that I should be an actor. And I wanted to be a director, because I thought that's the cool job. But then I studied acting and fell in love with it. So it was really a Jim, although my father, for some reason, always thought I should be an actor, but never pushed me into it. I think it's a very bad business to push anyone into, because it's a flip of a coin as to whether it's going to be successful or not.
Absolutely.
But my first time my father came to see me in a play, I was doing Sam Shepard's A Lie of the Mind, which is a ridiculously long play. It's like 3.5 hours long. We were doing it in London at the Battersea Arts Centre, and it happened to be one of the hottest summers in London, and there is no area of London that has air conditioning. It just doesn't exist. So the theatre was really hot. Anyway, so one day, it was a very small theatre, we were doing a play, and one day, my father, Dad, said, I want to come and see the play. I said, great. But I got very nervous, so I thought, well, sod it. If I'm going to be nervous, I'll let the whole cast be nervous. So I told everyone in the cast my dad was coming. So they were petrified. So anyway, he comes to see the play. I can't tell you how long it was. I mean, no disrespect to Sam Shepard, but it went on a bit. Anyway, it takes a while. When I came on stage, I suddenly heard these two dogs in the audience start barking, and I'm like, please God, don't tell me my father brought his two dogs to the theatre. So anyway, there's this huge kerfuffle, and whoever it is with the dogs is hauled out of the theatre and told to get out. And intermission, the lead actor came up to me and was like, I can't believe some total idiot brought his dogs. I was like, I don't know how to tell you this, but that was my dad. And then we went to the bar afterwards, and there he was with these two puppies in either pocket. Absolutely bewildered as to why he was thrown out of the theatre. But then but God bless him, he came back the next night. He claims he did. I can't actually remember if he did or not.
What was the best advice your father ever gave you about being in the entertainment industry?
I think it's a question of longevity. You know, you just stick it out. You have good years, bad years. Believe in yourself, because everyone else will believe in you for a minute and not the next. The advice my dad gave me on acting is, the huge difference between theatre and film is theatre is acting and film is reacting. The idea on film and any form of camera is just to be as natural as you can be, because you're in the most unnatural positions. You know, you're not really in space, you're in a office downtown in LA.
Right.
And you have to create this atmosphere that's not there. So the idea is to be as natural as you can.
And you did quite a bit of theater, actually. So how was your transition from theater to film? And do you expect to go back to theater?
Yeah, I love theater. I've done a lot in London, New York, Philadelphia. I love theater, and I would welcome going back. But at the moment, I'm stationed in Los Angeles, where it's much harder. There's far less theater around. Now, You know, I've got to be very careful in saying that. There's a lot of theatre around, but it's very rarely set up for theatre in Los Angeles, because it's not a money-making business for theatre. But no, the last play I did was in Philadelphia. It was fantastic. I loved it. Raw Boys by Dale Orlando Smith, and it was a fantastic experience. And it's very different, but you know, in theatre you get the wonderful month of rehearsals. You get to know your character and all the other characters and the other actors intimately. Every night it changes. It's something different that inspires you to do each scene. And it's very different. It's a very different craft from filmmaking. Filmmaking is much more sort of choreographed. It's very strategic.
Mm-hmm. Along with theater and film, you've also written your first screenplay.
Down Dog.
Tell me a little bit about the story behind Down Dog.
It's an amazing story, brilliantly written by myself. And my brother Jared Harris, is going to be in it, and we're producing it together with Julia Verdon, who's a wonderful producer in Hollywood. It's a great, it's kind of based on my, it's very loosely based on my life in Los Angeles over the 5 years. Insofar as my neighbor became a very good friend of mine, and it's all the sort of ridiculous situations we got ourselves into. It's a very much a dark comedy based on an actor in Los Angeles and a yoga instructor who are very out of place. And who see the world through very different eyes, and it's where it takes them. So it's a very very dark comedy, because comedies are in. If you can't do a horror movie, do a comedy.
Well, Jamie, thank you so much for joining us today here on LA Place TV. Make sure you check out Caesar: Rise of the Apes, released in theaters August 5th.